Hi guys, welcome to the channel. Today I want to do a quick video about the Samsung 870 EVO drives, more specifically about the failure rate of these drives. There's a lot of information written about the Samsung 990s and the 980 drives, but not much has been mentioned about the 870 EVO SATA drives. So it's gone a little under the radar a bit, and Samsung have been keeping quiet about the issues. This drive here is my own drive, which I took out of my system, and it failed this week with only about 10 terabytes written on it. I noticed it started giving me errors, CRC read errors, when I attempted to back it up with Macrium Reflect. So I tried to research why it wouldn't back up. So I came across a thread on the Tech Power forums, and it had a lot of users all experiencing the same type of problems. From the information I can gather, it seems that if your drive was manufactured before November 2021, it's most likely is error prone to failure. November seems to be the cutoff date when Samsung switched to a different manufacturing process for these drives. So it's likely that if your drive is made after this date, it's safe, but that's not 100% definitive. You can check your own drive by using software that displays the drive's smart data. Crystal Disk Info and Samsung Magician can show it. My drive here is manufactured in, as you can see, September 2021. So what you want to do is you want to open Samsung Magician and click the Smart button. What you want to do is find the uncorrectable error count row and see what the raw value is. Most of my good drives, like the 850s and 860 Samsung drives, show it as zero even after years of use and many terabytes written. Also, the runtime bad count should be zero, but a failing drive will show the uncorrectable error count in the thousands, and if yours says that, then that's a sure sign of a failing drive. You'll get read errors and data corruption. Right, there was a firmware update that was available which I flashed to the drive. The flashing was successful, but what happened was the drive became bricked and it was no longer detected by the system and the BIOS and obviously Windows as well. So now I'm in the process of RMing this drive back to Samsung and going through the grueling long process of taking pictures of all the sites and sending them that and then completing their online forms. I just wanted to make this video to inform other people and see if you've had similar experiences. If you have, leave a comment below in this video. That's all I wanted to say, and thanks for listening. Cheers.